Join Kids Hat Family. Will you help me to do my homework, Tia?
Tofu, it's dinner time and you haven't completed your homework yet? I hope you know that your teacher will be really angry.
I will do it after this cartoon, Tia. But please help me so that I can finish it fast.
You have been watching TV all day. You should get up and do your homework first.
My hand has been hurting since morning. I'm giving it some rest. Also, dear sister, will you please get my bag and pencil box from the room?
Excuses and more excuses. He should know his priorities right.
Did I forget it in school? What will I tell my teacher in school?
You should be more responsible, Tofu. You are a big boy now. Anyway, complete the rest of your homework at least now and be more careful next time onwards. So, Tofu, let me tell you a story. In a land far away, lived a hard-working and kind trader. Mostly, he traded in salt. He also had a horse that was very lazy and always avoided work. The trader used him to carry sacks of salt from one town to the other. Here, let me load these sacks up and let's go to the town across the river to sell this salt. I am so tired today. Why do I have to work every day? I wish I could sleep throughout the day. But no, I have to carry these loads of salt and move. Come on, horse. Start walking. Cross that bridge. Until then, I'll pack some food for myself.
The horse was crossing the river. Suddenly, he slipped and fell into the water. As he was carrying sacks of salt on his back, the salt got wet and dissolved in the water. So when the horse got up, the sacks on his back were lighter. The horse thought to himself,
"Wow, this seems to be a good idea. Every time I dip in the river, the salt would dissolve and my burden could be less. I must try doing this more often. I hope Master is not watching."
When the master reached the town to sell the salt, it weighed just half of what he loaded. Thinking it might be his miscalculation, he sold whatever salt was left and returned home with his horse. The next morning, he again loaded his horse with the sacks of salt and started to pack his food. The horse yet again started walking before him and made it to the bridge.
"I must try the dipping trick again before Master reaches here."
The trader got really confused as the sacks started weighing lesser every time. The horse purposely started slipping into the water every day so that the sacks became lighter. One day, the trader followed the horse. And hid in the bushes. To his surprise, he noticed the horse's new trick.
"Oh, that's so cunning. I must teach this lazy horse a lesson soon."
So the following day, instead of salt, the trader filled the sacks with cotton and tied him to the horse's back. Out of his new habit, the horse purposely fell into the river.
Oh no, no! What is happening today? What is going wrong? How are these sacks getting heavier? Oh, my back hurts! What?
This time, as the sacks were filled with cotton, it soaked water and became heavier. The horse dipped again and again in water, thinking to drain the salt off somehow, but all went in vain. He somehow managed to get up and cross the bridge. He sat on the ground and panted as the sacks had gotten really, really heavy. The trader laughed at him and said,
"Horse, I am your master. This is your work. I work very hard and worship my work. I don't make excuses or find tricks to fool others and avoid work. I must teach you to never repeat this and avoid your work."
The horse learned his lesson and never tried to avoid his work again. What a wise trader! Right, Tofu? He taught the lazy horse a good lesson. Come, let me give you the big bitter medicine for your hand. But hey, I can see it's totally fine now. Maybe you have forgotten about the pain.
Tia, I never had any pain. I just wanted to sit and watch cartoons. I was the lazy horse today. I am sorry, Tia. I'm really worried about my teacher scolding me tomorrow.
Here, take your books, Tofu. I also was the trader today. I just wanted you to learn a lesson. Now you should promise me that you will always do your work, and yes, I will help you with your homework.
Oh, thank you, Tia. Please, let's finish my homework quickly. I don't want to be lazy at all. I will always finish all my work before doing anything else. I promise you that.
What in the world are you trying to do?
I am trying to pluck those juicy fruits from this tree.
But do you think you will be able to pluck them? They are so high.
Oh, I wish I could fly and pluck those fruits. I so wish I had wings.
To wish is not bad, but one should be conscious about the consequences. Come, I'll tell you a story. The Tortoise and the Eagle. A young tortoise was lazing around the riverbank, looking at the birds flying in the sky. He stared at them and started thinking out aloud.
I wish I could fly like those birds. Up high in the sky, I'll watch the beautiful sceneries and beauty of the world from top of the world. Oh, I so wish that.
Nearby, an eagle was sitting on a stone, listening to what the tortoise was thinking out loud, and couldn't resist but ask,
Why do you want to fly? You should be happy with what you are gifted with.
I wish I could fly with no trouble of crawling on the ground.
So say that you want to fly because you don't want to crawl, not because you wish to see the world from the sky. Anyway, what will I get in return for making you fly in the sky?
I'll give you the riches of gold from the Red Sea.
So the eagle grabbed the tortoise in its claws and soared up high in the sky, making him see all the beautiful sceneries of the world. Flying higher in the clouds and closer to the stars, it was indeed a mesmerizing moment for the tortoise. While the eagle was flying over the riverbank, the rest of the tortoise were basking in the sun. Suddenly, the tortoise flying high up in the sky said,
"I wish my friends could watch me flying so high in the sky. I am sure they would get jealous watching me."
"What? Why would you want your friends to get jealous of you?"
"I want them to see that I can fly and they cannot. It's such a nice feeling."
"What an evil friend this tortoise is," thought the eagle. With this, the eagle dropped him on the ground and asked for his treasure.
"Now give me my reward."
"There is no reward. I was just kidding about the gold so that you could take me for a ride."
And with this, the tortoise left. The eagle couldn't tolerate his insult and decided to teach him a lesson. So the next day, the eagle went to the tortoise and said,
"Hey, would you like to go for a sky ride again?"
"Yes, sure, I would love to."
The eagle once again picked him up and clenched him in his claws. The tortoise, while enjoying the ride, said to the eagle,
"Why did you bring me again for the ride, even though I dishonored my promise of rewarding you?"
"That's because, tortoise, you wish to make your friends jealous, but at my cost. And now I'll let you enjoy the free fall."
The eagle let his claws loose and the tortoise went falling down, screaming for help and flying no longer. He crashed on the ground with a thud. Thanks to his shell, he didn't get injured. Soon, his old friends surrounded him and said,
"Hey, our young friend, you wanted to see the world from high up in the sky. To dream big is not a sin, but to dream it at the cost of others is just not justifiable."
"I have learnt my lesson now. I should be thankful to God for what I am blessed with. It was my shell only that saved my life. I should be happy with what I have, and also should not use others for my selfish reasons. I surely have learnt my lesson."
"Tia, now I know what you were trying to say. I learnt a lesson too. One should think about the consequences before one wishes for something. I should be happy with what I am blessed with. I should rather look for an alternative to pluck those fruits. Wait, I'll get a ladder."
"Tofu, you learn things quite fast."
"Tofu, make sure that everybody who goes through this gate gets a Rubik's Cube from Mr. Fuller's toy shop. Yes, Tia. I think it's a nice gesture from him. So many of my friends have decided to come to the fair for free giveaways from his store.
Hey, Tia. I will give you a pack of candies if you give me a big bag of Rubik's cubes. No, I don't want your candies. Well, you want something else then? Maybe two packs?
We don't want anything from you, and I am not going to give you anything other than the one cube that you're entitled to. Why did you do that, Tia? It was Barney, the bully. You could have taken anything from him.
Maybe. Anyway, do you want to hear a story while we wait for the people to come?
Yes. The Thief and the Dog. Once upon a time, a young family had a dog. They all loved him very much. Even the dog was very happy to be a part of that family. One night, after everyone had gone to sleep, the dog heard something at the kitchen window. It was a thief.
Hey boy, see what I have got you. A juicy piece of meat. I will give it to you if you let me in the house and if you don't bark.
I don't need your meat. Keep away from this house.
Oh, come on. I'll give you two big juicy meat pieces just for you. Here.
I don't want your meat. This is my master's house. You should leave.
Hearing the sounds coming from the kitchen, the dog's master woke up. He came down to the kitchen.
What's going on here? Who is here?
Hearing the master of the house, the thief quickly ran away. The master saw the pieces of meat and understood what had happened. You are such a good dog. You didn't let the thief come inside the house, though he offered you such good meat. I will reward you with more meat for this loyal act.
Oh, that's why you didn't take the gifts from Barney. You are loyal to Mr. Fuller, Tia.
Absolutely correct, Tofu. When you're honest and loyal, you don't need a bribe from someone to do your job. Got it?
For your favorite rhymes, stories, and more, join Kids Heart Family. Subscribe here.